Now let us look at this question. This is again a very, very interesting question. And this is very much related to the previous question that we have done. Okay, so let us read it, the problem first. They are saying, a link has a transmission speed of 10 raised to the power 6 bits per second. That is the transmission speed. Or transmission speed means it is, they are discussing about the efficiency, the bandwidth. Transmission speed means they are discussing about the bandwidth. It uses data packets of size 1000 byte each. Data packets of size 1000 byte each. Assume that the acknowledgement has negligible transmission delay. Negligible transmission delay. That means acknowledgement does not have any transmission delay. We are going to assume the transmission delay for acknowledgement as zero. And that its propagation delay is same as the data propagation delay. Also assume that the processing delay at the nodes are negligible. Again, processing delay and the buffer delay, they are assuming as negligible. The efficiency of stop and wait protocol is set up in this setup is exactly 25%. Efficiency is already given. This is 25%. That is so good, right? So efficiency is equal to 25%. That is already given. Or you can say 25 divided by 100, which is equal to 1 by 4. So efficiency is already given as 1 by 4. Okay, good. The value of the one-way propagation delay in millisecond is, they're asking about the propagation delay. Very nice question, right? So how to solve this one? So transmission speed, that is bandwidth, is given as 10 raised to the power 6 bits per second, right? So this is given in bits, so we can convert this as bytes and we can also convert it as megabyte, okay? We already know that if we say 10 raised to the power 3 bits, then that is also called as 1 kilobits. When we have 10 raised to the power 6 bits, then that is also called as 1 megabits. Right, so make sure I'm writing bits here, I'm not writing bytes. Now let us try to solve this one. We already know what is the efficiency. So efficiency is given as 1 by 4. And we know the formula of efficiency is TT upon TT plus 2 into TP. TT plus 2 into TP. And we know the value of N or eta. So it will be equal to 1 by 4. Now if you try to solve this one, then you can find out it is 4TT. Is equal to TT plus 2 into TP, or you can say 3 transmission time is equal to 2 into propagation time. 2 into propagation time. Now they're asking there what is the propagation delay? Okay, they are already giving you the bandwidth, they're already giving you the size of the data packet, and the size of the data packet is given as I've seen it somewhere. So the packet is of 1000 bytes each. Make sure it is bytes. It is byte. It is an important term. Okay. So packet size here, packet size, or you can say the length of the packet is 1000 bytes. 1000 bytes. Or you can say it is 8000 bits. 8000 bits. It is a very, very important thing that we are going to use. So, and they're asking what is the propagation delay, and propagation delay is 2 into TP. Hence, this TP, propagation delay, can also be written as 3 into transmission time divided by 2. It's so simple, guys, so simple, right? So we are just going to use this one. We are going to take it here. So it is propagation delay is equal to 3 into transmission time, and transmission time can be written as length of the data packet upon bandwidth. So here transmission time is can also be written as length upon bandwidth, and in denominator we have 2, so it is 3 upon 2 into length upon bandwidth. So TP is 3 into length of data packet is 1000 bytes, or you can say 8000 bits, and bandwidth is given as 10 raised to power 6 bits per second. So it is given as 10 raised to power 6 bits per second. So per second is seconds is going to be multiplied in the numerator. So this will be cancelled. Now here it is 3 into 8000. So if you cancel it with 2, so it will be written as 4000. So it will be TP is equal to 3 into 4000 divided by 10 raised to the power 6 seconds. 10 raised to the power 6 second. Now there's one more very, very interesting fact here. They're already asking in terms of millisecond, and we got the answers in terms of seconds. So most of the time in examination hall, student makes these kind of mistakes that they forget to convert the units, right? So if you do not convert the units, obviously you're not going to get the correct answer. And especially for these kind of questions, which are fill-in-the-blanks kind of question, and these fill-in-the-blanks kind of questions is kind of a death trap for the students. Even a student already know the concept, but just a small silly mistake can lead him to zero marks in such kind of questions. And these kind of questions can actually change your ranks because they're so simple. Everyone is going to do it. I mean, any student who is having a good rank, obviously, they will attempt it correctly. So you cannot afford to miss these kind of questions, right? So we have to convert these seconds into millisecond. So how will you convert it to millisecond? You just multiply it by 1000, then the answer will become in millisecond. Why? Because in 1 second, there are 1000 milliseconds. So again, you can take these zeros, you can take these zeros. So this can be written as 3 into 4 multiplied by 10 raised to power 6 upon 10 raised to power 6 milliseconds, which is again equivalent to saying 12 milliseconds. Therefore, the correct answer to this problem is 12 milliseconds. It is 12 milliseconds. I hope you enjoyed this question. This is a very, very simple question. Okay, so do not make any such silly mistakes about converting the units in the examination hall, because then you are going to face a lot of problems. And that is a death trap for the students who are really good with their concepts. Okay, now let us go to the next video here.